A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 10th May, on the front page you have Supreme Court pushes for full strength of 21. So, Collegium is against rethink on new judges and adds two new names. So, these are the profiles of four judges which have been recommended to be elevated to the Supreme Court now. These two are reiteration of previous recommendations. So the government can send back the names once to the Supreme Court Collegium and then they have to make the appointments. But that also has seen that government delays appointments even after the names come back. And these are two fresh recommendations also. So the strength of the Supreme Court recommend as such, which has been approved, the sanctioned judicial strength as such is 31 judges. So, if these four judges are added without delay, then the court would reach its full sanction strength. Then this is government denies perjury charges in Rafael case. So, it has informed Supreme Court that petitioners relied on media leaks and not on CAG report. So, this is the charges, you know, in Rafael case which have been which has been filed against the government. So, perjury basically means lying on the oath. So, what the opposition and what the petitioners oppose and have filed in the petition before the Supreme Court is that the government lied before the court. So, they say this, the petitioners are saying that government lied based on media leaks and not on CAG report. Then, on page 5 you have, did Malegaon accused train Gauri murder conspirators? So now the investigation is on to find out if Kalsangra and Dange were involved in training the murder conspirators of the writer and actors Gauri Lankesh, Narendra Dabolkar, Govind Pansari and M.M. Kalburgi murders. On page 6 you have, Gujarat facing massive water crisis. Except the Narmada, all other water bodies and dams have negligible water. So this is what the chief minister himself says. So you can see 561 villages are getting water through tankers, which make 1581 trips daily. So it's state authorities have deployed police along Narmada canals to ensure that water is lifted through pumps by farmers. So there's a huge water crisis here. The government has cut water supply to industries by 50%. The state received only 73.87% of average rainfall in 2018. So again, we're awaiting the monsoon and presently the situation is dire. Then on page 7 you have, Supreme Court frowns on foreigners' tribunals plan. So the Supreme Court has questioned the proposal by the Assam government to quickly open 1,000 foreigners' tribunals all across the northeastern state of Assam to try suspected illegal immigrants. So actually there are already around 100 foreigners tribunals in Assam and now the plan is to have 1,000 more open. So the Supreme Court frowned on this. It said that how can the government propose such a plan without a basic study on how to implement it, because for 1,000 tribunals they would need at least 1,000 judicial officers to preside over them, and where will they get them overnight? So how many advocates above the age of 35 would be willing to join? So these are the questions CGI raises. Court also questioned the Assam government earlier when it favored release of inmates after ensuring steps to monitor them. That, you know, because detention centers, there are 5 detention centers across Assam. So since these inmates in these detention centers are living in dire conditions and also they are overcrowded. So what the Assam government proposes, those who had, you know, stayed there for a particular period of time and taking, so they would be released as such is what the Assam government had proposed when the central government earlier had objected to it. Now it says that it is in favor of releasing them provided that a foolproof mechanism was evolved to track them. So they would be released because what happens is when these foreigners tribunals rule that a particular person is illegal immigrant, a foreigner, then they are placed in these in detention centers, and what is the next step is actually that they should be sent back to the country from where they have come. But then these people, they don't have any documents. The country to which they claim to be, you know, part of the country also needs documentation to accept them, to accept their know, claim, but then when that does not take place, they languish in these jails. So the extradition process is also tedious. So that is why now the Assam government itself proposed that they be released and they should be tracked. So Supreme Court earlier had frowned on this idea too, but now it says yes, they can be released provided that a foolproof mechanism was evolved to track them. Then next is, 5 years on, relief still far away for jailed Delhi University professor. So this is Sai Baba, Professor G.N. Sai Baba, who is a professor of Delhi University. He has been held for Maoist links in Nagpur's jail's Anda cell. He has been arrested in 2014 on charges of having Maoist links and has been in jail for so long, 5 years on, and he's still in jail. He is 90% physically handicapped. And he's been languishing in this jail on charges of having Maoist links. So this is also a significant case of human rights. As I said, there have been many, many activists who have come in support of Professor G.N. Sai Baba. And then you have Navy joins exercises in South China Sea. So this is regarding Navy ship INS Kolkata and Shakti, which are participating in the joint exercise in South China Sea. So this is group sailing with US, Japan and Philippines. This is from May 3 to 9, which happened, and the Navy also, Indian Navy also participated in it. On the editorial page, the first editorial is loud and clear. So this is that New Delhi must snap out of its denial on the discord with the US on market access. So this is regarding India-US relations. The US Commerce Secretary recently gave a speech and it had criticized India of not removing tariff and non-tariff barriers for US companies. So this is the status of India-US relations presently, which is discussed here. And second is endless war. So this talks about how US must put pressure on Taliban to heed the Afghan government's concerns. So Taliban talks have been going on with USA. It ignores the Afghan government in place and it conducts terror attacks too. So this is in that context. The lead article, a vote for the sake of parliament. So this talks of how constituents must weigh their candidates' commitment to restoring the dignity of legislature. So when elections take place, we're actually electing a legislator, an MP, who would be representing our region in our constituency in the parliament. So this talks of how vote should be for that candidate's commitment to restoring the dignity of legislature. And this is by established law and procedure. So this article talks of the CGI case. So it says that there's no violation of natural justice for the simple reason that it is not a judicial inquiry. Then on Fridays on op-ed page, you have Parle coverage, which has a question and two viewpoints given. So this is regarding farm loan waivers. It says, are farm loan waivers a political gimmick? So one viewpoint is that, you know, of course, there are several interventions needed on the demand and supply side to alleviate farm distress. But how do these farm loan waivers work? There are two viewpoints given here. So this is important. Then there's no important news on international page. It's continuation of previous news regarding North Korea firing missiles and Europe and Iran's, you know, stands on the nuclear agreement. Iran says that it will defy the nuclear deals provisions, while Europe rejects such ultimatum by Iran and says that it stands by nuclear agreement. Then on business page, you have bank credit grows 13.2% in financial year 2019-20, so 18-19. So this is regarding loans to services and retail sector, which have spurred the growth. So this is RBI data. Below you have finance panel to reconcile data. So voices have been raised over credibility of various data. So 15th Finance Commission has said that it will be reconciling data that it gets from various sources amid serious concerns over the credibility of macro data. Then there's no important news on the last page as well. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aashar.com and also download the PDFs which are made available by the end of the day. Thank you.